Oh boy, the future of Anthem's still not looking particularly great or confidence-inspiring. So just about everything that could have gone wrong with Anthem has gone wrong, right? Its development cycle was a nightmare for developers, its launch was a nightmare for consumers, and the roadmap continues to be a nightmare for remaining players. The game did finally see the release of The Cataclysm, though, which was supposed to come out all the way back in May, before it went through a public test server period throughout June and July, before finally going live for everyone in August. The general consensus seems to be that The Cataclysm in and of itself isn't bad, per se. It is new content that adds to what's been a bare-bones experience. It does bolster the loot here and there, but it's overall seen as underwhelming and certainly not enough to revitalize what many signs indicate to be a slowly decaying title. 3 months The Cataclysm was delayed for, having released 5 months after the game's launch, and for all the time Anthem went without substantial new content, one could hardly call The Cataclysm worth the wait. If it's going to continue to take BioWare this long to release middling content updates, there's just no way Anthem will recover, and with the core team having moved on to Dragon Age, this pattern of slow and middling content updates continuing could be a possibility. On top of that, we have the most recent development surrounding Anthem. One of the core members of the team has left the studio. The following information was relayed directly by Ben Irving, who was one of the lead producers of the game and took charge of Anthem after BioWare's core team moved on to Dragon Age. He announced yesterday on August 15th, 2019, that after 8 long years at BioWare, he's leaving the studio to pursue new ventures. His string of tweets reads as follows. After 8 amazing years at BioWare, I've made the decision to move on and have accepted an exciting opportunity at another gaming company. Since the first time I played Baldur's Gate many, many years ago, BioWare was the dream place I always wanted to work. I will forever be grateful to all the people who gave me the chance to work on great products with amazing people. I believe Anthem has a bright future. There's a great team working on it, and I look forward to following its progress and playing it from the sidelines. I've really enjoyed interacting with the Anthem community, streams, Twitter, and Reddit. Through the good times and the tough times. You all are in great hands with Jesse Anderson and Andrew Johnson, and have been for some time now. I wish nothing but the best for all of you, Ben. So there's obviously not a lot of detail there in regards to why Ben Irving decided to leave. It would seem as though he did get an offer from another gaming company, though which one wasn't specified, but there aren't exact details in regards to why Ben Irving is suddenly departing. Is this something he had planned for a while now? Did the strains of Anthem's rough launch finally make him clock out of his own volition and go somewhere else? Did Anthem's woes lead to higher-ups deciding that maybe it's time to seek new leadership? Or is it a combination of these factors? Hard to say with what little information is out there, but seeing leadership of a game in such rough waters leave like that is certainly not a super encouraging sign. While developers leaving studios is not an uncommon occurrence, the timing of such occurrences can sometimes be pretty telling, and with a game like Anthem, a game in dire straits, the sudden departure of a member of leadership certainly doesn't bode well. Recall that something similar happened with Mass Effect Andromeda. This was a game that was spearheaded by Aaron Flynn, who you may recall left the studio shortly after the title's failed launch to be replaced by the returning Casey Hudson. And then it was a month after Aaron Flynn left that BioWare announced that additional support for Andromeda single-player content would be cancelled, confirming the studio would not develop and release the DLC that was teased in the game's campaign. Then again, others could look at Anthem's change in leadership to mean that maybe there's opportunity for Anthem to course correct and head in a more appropriate direction under new leadership. Ben does claim in his tweet that there is a great team working on it, insisting that the game will not be abandoned, essentially, but here's the thing, I'd be hard-pressed to just take BioWare's word for it because it's not necessarily up to them. We have seen this happen before. BioWare makes some kind of commitment to keep improving their game and to stick with it, and then EA swoops in and denies the studio of that opportunity. For example, with Mass Effect Andromeda, 2 weeks after its disastrous launch, on April 2017, then-project lead Aaron Flynn published a post detailing some updates they were working on for the game while stating things like this. Since launch, our team has been poring over your comments and feedback, looking looking to discover what you like about the game as well as areas we can evolve or improve. And this is just a taste of what's in store as we continue to support Mass Effect Andromeda. And as always, you all play an important role in that. We want to hear from you about your experiences, both what you love about the game and what you'd like to see changed. We are listening and we're committed to partnering with you as we continue to explore the Andromeda Galaxy together. The implication there was that they weren't abandoning Andromeda, that they would keep improving it, that they would stick with it, that we'd get patches and content updates. But then the following month, on May 2017, we began to hear reports that BioWare Montreal had been downsized and that the whole Mass Effect franchise had been put on hold. And then the month after that, on August 2017, the announcement was made that support for Andromeda would be dropped. The fact of the matter is that whatever assurances BioWare developers and leads provide, whatever their intentions might be, have proven to carry very little weight because it's ultimately EA who gets to decide the fate of the studio and its games. So I'm looking more closely at what EA is doing and saying, and as I mentioned in one of my previous videos, the pattern of events for Anthem is strikingly similar to what happened to Andromeda before its abandonment. Recall that after Andromeda's tumultuous release, EA stated in their May 2017 earnings call that, quote, BioWare has continued to support Mass Effect and the new team is doing some amazing things, and you'll hear more about that in the months to come. This is parallel to how shortly after Anthem's tumultuous release, EA talked in their May 2019 earnings call about their long-term commitment towards Anthem, stating that BioWare is focused on improving the game and committed to providing content updates and in-game events that will, quote, enhance and expand the Anthem experience. It's a mirror image of what EA said about Andromeda. Back to Andromeda, fast forward to 2 months after that May 2017 earnings call, and during EA's July 2017 earnings call, Andromeda barely got mentioned, which is parallel to how Anthem barely got mentioned during EA's July 2019 earnings call. Again, these events are like mirror images, and it wasn't long after EA decided to stop talking about Andromeda during their earnings calls that support for it was dropped. So one has to wonder if a similar fate awaits Anthem, given we're at a point where EA isn't talking about that game in recent earnings calls, if history will repeat itself. If you ask me, it's stuff like this that act as far better indicators for what the future might potentially hold for a game than assurances from BioWare staff who don't have as much control over circumstances. Ben Irving insists that he believes Anthem has a bright future and that there's a great team working on it, but EA's pattern of behavior seems to indicate otherwise. Even if there is a team working on Anthem, I have to wonder who's left at this point. Are we talking about a tangible, sizable team with lots of talented veterans to really help bolster the experience, or are we dealing with some kind of skeleton crew here? It's easy to get the impression that it's the latter, given how slow patches, updates, and progress has been rolling out for Anthem over the last 5 months. Something else Ben Irving pointed out in his farewell post was that Anthem is now at the hands of Jesse Anderson and Andrew Johnson. But both of these guys are members of the community engagement team. Do they have a hand in Anthem's post-launch development, or was Ben simply referring to the community specifically being at the hands of these two? If so, who's actually steering the Anthem ship now? We know for a fact that Michael Gamble, Anthem lead producer, and Mark Dara, Anthem executive producer, and the only reason Anthem was in some kind of playable state at launch, have moved on to Dragon Age 4. So I guess that leaves Chad Robertson, whose role, according to his Twitter description, is head of live service. Not the most flattering of titles in the eyes of gamers who have grown sick and tired of the term live service, due to the nefarious elements it represents. Now, Chad did say back in May 2019 that he's got a big team between BioWare Austin and Edmonton focused and motivated on improving the game. But it's been 3 months since then, and a lot can change in that time, particularly where EA's disposition is concerned. And let's face it, EA's disposition is really the only one that matters. No matter how motivated BioWare might be to improve Anthem, if EA decides that it's best to just cut their losses, Anthem's done. Similarly with Andromeda, I'm sure there were plenty of people in BioWare Montreal who were inspired to improve Andromeda and to release that DLC that the campaign teased, but then they were just shut down and they didn't get that opportunity. So no matter how motivated BioWare might be to improve Anthem, if EA decides that it's best to just cut their losses, Anthem's done. Nothing set in stone right now, but let's just say EA doesn't have a particularly good track record of sticking with a troubled game. Their knee-jerk reaction to any game flop is to just abandon ship, which is why there's such a big graveyard full of games and studios in EA's backyard. Combine all of these factors, EA's past history along with EA's present pattern, with a sudden and untimely departure of Anthem lead producer Ben Irving, which again just doesn't bode well for the state of the game the way things are going, and which somewhat mirrors Aaron Flynn's departure shortly after Andromeda's failure and shortly before support for Andromeda was dropped, and it's hard not to feel uneasy about this chain of events and what this all means for the future. It's hard not to wonder, looking at all of these factors, whether and support for Anthem is also imminent. The future is still unwritten though, so you never know. Maybe EA has more of a commitment to Anthem, and the publisher sees it as more salvageable than, say, Andromeda because it's more of a live service than Andromeda was, and perhaps Ben Irving's departure marks a shift in workflow for the troubled project, and maybe things can start to pick up from here on out. We still haven't seen any investigative reports from Kotaku or whatever that EA has scaled down the Anthem team or anything like that yet, unlike with Andromeda, so that's something. Then again, EA is a creature of habit, always claiming they'll learn from their mistakes and improve moving forward, only to have every intention of repeating the same mistakes in the name of revenue, particularly where loot box implementation is concerned. But this also goes true for how they launch their games in half-baked states before later abandoning them. Remember what EA said about Andromeda after all the backlash? Then EA executive Patrick Söderlund stated the following. With Mass Effect, the game wasn't maybe as finished as people wanted it to be. Of course we take that seriously. What we do is we look at that toward the Mass Effect team themselves, but we also look at what learnings can we apply to the rest of the organization so that this doesn't get replicated in another place around EA. Of course, anything that comes out of BioWare, we'll apply thorough dialogue and change to ensure we get the best possible game in the market. EA basically made a commitment here to not let Mass Effect Andromeda repeat itself, but then fast forward 2 years and we have got Anthem, a project that not only repeats Andromeda but is arguably worse in many regards in terms of how incomplete and how compromised it was at launch and how incomplete and compromised it still is. For all the times they claim they'll learn and they'll fix their mistakes, EA is a company that just does not seem to learn, a company that I've found to be quite predictable in their behavioral patterns and in their corporate speak. It's often quite easy to anticipate where things are going based on the things they say and do, or the things they don't say and don't do. It's seldom surprising when the company does something nefarious these days. Everyone just sort of expects it at this point. And right now, as enthused as BioWare might be to keep this game alive, everything about EA's behavior tells me that it's not impossible that it's only a matter of time before Anthem's development starts ramping down. This is just my own opinion though, we don't really know anything for sure right now, but I think it's safe to say that the only way BioWare can salvage Anthem from the chopping block is by speaking EA's language, money. Anthem has to start being highly profitable sooner rather than later, as that's the only thing worthwhile to EA executives. And here's the thing, even if Anthem does by some miracle make this incredible comeback and gets to a point where it does get back a lot of the players that they lost and become profitable, I fear for the way EA might swoop in when the fruit is finally ripe and then start to spread its tendrils. It's what's happening with Apex Legends right now. In contrast to Anthem, this game had an incredible launch and got a lot of positive reception, with many players agreeing that it's a lot of fun with very solid core mechanics and overall design. Apex Legends is a game that EA apparently had little to no influence in during its development, according to Respawn, and that shows. But now that Apex Legends has become ripe for the picking, the worms over at EA have started to dig their way in, and now we're seeing crap like the Iron Crown event, where the game's rarest and most coveted item is paywalled behind having to purchase 24 loot boxes before players gain access to the ability to buy the item for another $35, amounting to around $200 worth of loot boxes and coins, whose cost can be brought down to $170 if you buy the right Apex coins packs. That's what's so frustrating about an EA-published game. If it has a rough launch, it's more likely than not that it will get no chance to recover. And if a game does somehow recover or launches as an instant hit, there's always a risk EA will find a way to ruin it somehow with their greedy mandates. That's been the general pattern for a game company obsessed with live services and their potential for infinite monetization. A game company that's less concerned with making the game and more concerned about the monetization surrounding them. But anyway, I digress. There you have it, folks. My general thoughts on Ben Irving's departure and what that may or may not say about Anthem's future prospects based on EA's recent pattern of behavior. Let us know in the comments below if you think Ben Irving's departure signals good or bad tidings for Anthem, and let us know what your general thoughts are on Anthem's future prospects based on everything that's going on right now. With that, I would like to end this news update and discussion video. Thank you for tuning in. To be further updated on all things gaming news, reviews, and discussions, stay tuned right here on Yong Yeah. I'll see you guys next time. Yong out.